This hand is pretty slow. And those cards are not actually very good against him. Yeah, I think this is probably the kind of hand that you're not really happy with, but you kind of have to keep. I mean, yeah. That's an improvement. That's a better improvement. We shouldn't run that last turn, though. Call. So I have the options of playing this and this, or this. I think next turn he gets to 6 mana, which is a pretty dangerous amount of mana. But when am I gonna have 7? Only 2 turns. I'll have taken 6 from this guy already. Is it worth it? Taking 6 damage to try to cancel his 6 drop? I have actually not seen a 6 drop yet. He didn't have 6 knowledge, but he didn't have 7. So from his plummet play, I can probably conclude that he has a 7 mana 7 7. It's the only way it makes any sense. But... or the 7 mana Archangel. Or any other 7 mana guy. If I play this guy and he plays a 6-4, then I guess I can play another one and double block, so it's not that terrible. Here, I'm gonna leave an island up. I'm not gonna block with this guy, and maybe island suggests something. Oh, that was good. Now I can probably play this. Yeah, I think playing the Silver Ranger and keeping cancel mana up seems to be the best choice here. What's that still doing in his deck? Alright, you can play. I'm not gonna play. I'm not gonna attack. Because if he somehow deals with this guy, like pass phase, then I'm gonna take four and this guy's gonna die. So I'd rather just keep this. I'm not really afraid of tapping out at this point, because he only has one card and I have the mind control. And I'm still at 16, so I don't have to mind control this to stay alive. So if he does play a gigantic guy, just mind control it. Do I block here? So what's this gonna do to me? 9 damage? That's not so bad. Assuming he doesn't trade. If he trades, I'm fine with it. Yeah, 9 damage does not seem like a problem. Within here, I have to tap the elf. Because otherwise, I'll have to block with it and it's gonna die, and I won't be able to cancel his next play. And I can't tap him. I mean, I could tap him before blockers, but that still leaves me unable to cancel his next play. He's at 0 cards. So I'm still gonna block this. Still taking 9 damage. Yeah, okay, that resolves. Yeah, I'm just gonna block here. This guy's gonna have to block this at some point anyway. What is that gonna do for him? Well, it's 2 more damage when he does get to attack. Which is gonna put me at 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, it's 11 damage, puts me to 5, which is not as comfortable. But I think at this point, do I just have to mind control his guy? Okay, this resolves. If I draw an island, that's gonna be really good, but. Or this. I mean, now I can attack, and if he actually attacks with everything, I just kill him the next turn. So, I die to Inspire Charge. But if I'm in control to this guy, don't I? I guess I don't die to Inspire Charge if I'm in control to this guy. But yeah, I think my chances of winning are just so much better by playing this. And it's 11 damage. Oh, okay. So I'm dead to Spire Charge, and I can probably beat any other card.
Pacifism would not be awesome either, but I did not die to pacifism. Yep. I think the play here is just mind control his unicorn and pass. This is gonna trade with this and this, which is good for me, I guess, but not a trade I wanna make. Oh, if he does block like that, I kill both his guys, then this is no longer a threat, and then this gets to attack. But if I mind control his unicorn, how do I lose? It seems just better to mind control the unicorn. But he needs a removal spell. Or a pass. Well, two of them. Or I kill him next turn. Or naturalize, which we probably didn't board anything because I didn't play an air attacks game. Even though this is still in his deck, so you never know. Yeah, one card and I have a cancel, so he's dead. Team.